Interesting castle music. Oh, such a rockin' tune. A rockin' tune. I need to LP Metroid Prime now, too. Seriously. I'm telling you, man! This is so cool. I don't know why. There's something hilariously cool about, like, what I'm doing right now. I'm recording a link to the past randomizer, just because I felt like it. And I'm doing it with a Samus skin and playing Metroid tunes. Like, what the hell is this? I just wish I could have added more songs to the playlist, but I'm worried about volume discrepancy, like I mentioned before. Because not only is my Metroid Prime 2 soundtrack really quiet compared to the Prime 1, and especially Prime 3. Prime 3 has a really loud soundtrack. My files have high amplitude, or whatever. You know what I just remembered? I have the magic mirror, so I could totally go up to the Tower of Hera. Oh, and since I have since I'm using open, I can't actually go. Since I'm using the open thing, I actually need the lantern to be able to see at all in all dark areas. Okay, die, please. Sheesh. What do we got? Magic powder. Could. Range not big enough for that, for all those arpeggios. Oh, and I always forget when it goes down or when it hangs on for a bar. Makes me sound like I don't know this music when I really do. Yeah, again, I feel like I have to reiterate, you know, man, I may have gotten the tempered sword within 20 minutes, but let me tell you something, it doesn't matter how powerful your sword is if you don't have the bow, because you still can't kill the red Garayas or the red Igors. And you need to kill those guys to get through both of the Eastern Palaces. Both the Eastern Palace and Pod, as it were. Oh, I'm getting a Discord message. What is it? Don't be something urgent, please. Oh, it's just an announcement from somebody else's. For somebody else's stream. Oh, well, no. No, I was gonna say I should go to the secret passage, but I can't because I don't have the lantern. I need the lantern to be able to see in there. Excuse me. Okay, so if I go up to the graveyard, though, then I can fall down into the part of the secret passage where the three things are, and I only need to go that far. There's no chests earlier in that dungeon. There's no chests in the... What the hell? Oh my gosh, you're so stupid. I don't know my way around this world for shit. I mean, I do. Better than I know, like, the, I mean, I can find my way around, but... You know. Like, that's always been a pet peeve of mine in these 2D Zeldas. Is, like, completely arbitrary blockades that force you to go on a detour for no reason. It's like, why can't I just walk through the trees? Does it really hurt the experience that much? You know, if I can walk, you know, like, that didn't hurt the experience in Breath of the Wild. But no, when you play this game, no, of course you can't just walk from Kakariko Village and walk east to the castle. No, you have to go up first, or you have to go down. It's like, geez, it's like the land looks connected on the map, but no, there's trees in the way. And don't even get me started on the Game Boy Zeldas. I'll tell you something. Going to a place is never as simple as going there. You have to go somewhere else first, and not just because you need an item that you don't have. Usually there's some crap in the way. It's like, oh, I can't go this way because there's a ledge here, so I have to go down 12 tiles on the map, and then go up another, and then go right, and then up, and then right, and then down, and then go right, so also I can walk around a single fucking tree that just happens to be in my way. What a catastrophic pain in the ass. Oh, for Pete's sake. Just let me in there, man. Jeez. I'm telling you. Oh, that felt good. Man, those rats drop lots of goodies. Alright, what do we got? Can't wait to see, etc. The map. The Titan's Mitt. A key. A key. Stupid. So I'm basically just gonna record this as long as I feel like it. And at the end of the recording, I'll just, like, splice it into videos and upload it whenever. I'll just have, like, this backlog for when Chrono Trigger catches up to Chrono Trigger DS's streams. Which, neither of those have even started yet. I'm recording this in advance. It's like I have this extra playthrough. I have this just-in-case series to upload when I have nothing else to upload. Which is a good thing to have, I think. Like, if I don't get an episode of Pokemon Emerald recorded, just put up some rando. Oh, and I have the Titan's Mitt now, so I can go to a few more... I could go to the fucking Skull Woods right now if I wanted to. This is just a great fairy fountain. But I would be lying if I said I wasn't tempted to visit it, literally just because I love the design of the great fairies in this game that much. Oh, I keep forgetting I don't have a shield. Boo doo 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 doo. I wonder how many people in the universe have walked around up here. Because you sure as hell don't see any experienced players ever do that. Dabble, dabble, toil and trouble, bring me a mushroom! It's like, the dialogue in this randomizer is just, like, so silly. It'd be cool if they hacked in a dark mirror in these randomizers, you know? Oh, Chozo Ruins Depths. What a nice cucka feeling inducing song. Tell you what. Oh, I can come in here. There's two items in here. Unfortunately, no cute fairy. The hookshot! Wait, where's my... Period. What the fuck? Oh, right. I set it to a different... I changed the configuration on my Wii U Pro controller because when I had it set to enter, it was, like, accidentally doing stuff when I hit start in a game. It was, like, having background inputs that fucked everything up. I wonder what color the blue and red male are gonna be on Samus. Because, can't really tell. Okay, I can't get anything around here. I have the hook shot, but that doesn't actually... Maybe there are some dark world palace I could do right now. I don't really know. Without a bow, there are a lot of places that you'd be surprised to not be able to complete. But I also don't know this game as well, so it's possible I'm talking out my ass. Huh. Anyway, I can stop by the potion shop for a free sample from the cute attendant girl. Hit up the church and get all my health back. Hit on the girl and get all my health back. You know. Jeez. Anyway, let's get out of here. I wonder if you went into the game files, if she would be called Maple. Probably not. I wonder if that might not even be a girl. Oh, yeah. Cross the bridge. Let's go up to Death Mountain. What the hell? Music is so weird to be playing as I'm wandering around the peaceful, idyllic Hyrule countryside. Well, I am in a graveyard right now, but you know. I'd like to know, like, exactly how the AI of those soldiers works, because, like, I've seen them, like, you know, notice things, and in such a way that feels, like, really surprisingly organic. Hey, aw. Oh, you know what? I can't see a fucking thing in here. Never mind. Well, I could go to Skull Woods. There are some treasure chests in Thieves Town that could possibly contain the lantern. I mean, I also could probably just fumble my way through that cave, but the idea of that does not appeal to me. Man, you guys coming at me running at the same time, two clowns singing with one voice. Give me a break. Once we get into the dark world, the music around here. Well, I didn't need to switch to those. I'm gonna stay in the dark world. Once we get to the dark world, some of this darker music will feel a lot more apt. Yop. What? Oh right. I'm fucking. I don't have the moon pearl. Oh shit. Okay, well, there are still right, I don't have the Moon Pearl. Oh my gosh, I love that it's Zero Suit Samus instead of the bunny. That's hilarious. Wait, no. Use the mirror. Oh my gosh, I turned into a redhead. That's peculiar. I love that sound. I don't know why I love this sound so much. The sound of not being able to use an item in this game, it just sounds good. It's pleasing to my ears because it's so, like, it's so solid and, you know, I don't know how to describe it. It's just like, I seriously don't know how to describe why I find that sound so appealing. It just has like a it has just enough punch that complements the flat notes. It sounds really good. I really like it. Anyway, that's enough of that. Run! I can't believe I didn't kill that thing. Must have gotten hit by the beam. I don't think there's anything in here, or rather down here. Okay. Might just be a fairy fountain. No, it's you. It's the guy who talks about you destroying all of his pots. Yeah, sure. What's in here? Here's a great fairy fountain. I would love a cup of tea. I would love to. Well, I can't. Oh man, I can't come up with. I would love to. Cabbage cup of tea with you. That is the stupidest thing I've ever said in my life. Oh, phase on mines. Oh, Brussels sprouts. Dun 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 dun. No, the bombs. Thank you. This music kicks so much ass. I wanted to try and write this in like Famitracker and make like a Metroid 1 remix of this, but the drums are just so the bow. Victorious. Kohiro. Now we can go to the Eastern Palace. Fun time. Maybe in the Eastern Palace we'll find I don't know, the Moon Pearl or whatever. I mean, anything, honestly. I don't think I ever finished saying before, it would be cool if they hacked this game to be like if we just started, like, taking Super Metroid and A Link to the Past and combining them in every way it was possible to, like, make a Super Metroid ROM hack where you get swords instead of beams, and a Metroid and a Super and A Link to the Past remake where you get, or ROM hack where you get beams instead of swords, like you have Link shooting an arm cannon like Super Metroid, and Samus fighting with a sword in ZBs. That'd be hilarious. Right, Eastern Palace. Oh, you know what? There's also chests in in his house that I can get with bombs that I totally forgot about. Where are you? I always forget where Sahasrara's house is, but it's right here. I don't forget where it is. I just, well, I guess I do. What? Huh. Did he tell me which one? There we go. There's the Moon Pearl. There's the hammer. Good lord. And there's another heart container. I'm telling you. Ugh. Do I need to set this thing to a harder difficulty? I don't know. Looking at the list of changes in hard mode, it's a little intimidating. Like, max 14 hearts. Like, I can't even reliably... Well, I can probably reliably beat Ganon with 20 hearts, but... I'm telling you. I'm not that good at the Ganon fight. I don't understand. Well, I can totally understand how you could be good at that fight, because, and obviously I've seen many people be good at that fight, but I am not good at it. That is a fight that has, that you can very much get better at. In fact, a lot of the boss fights in this game are very much fights that you can improve on your skills. This is a game where boss fights, you know, really do get easier the better you are at the game. And that sounds like a stupid thing to say, but it really isn't. I mean, you know, once you hit a certain point in Ocarina of Time's skill, every single fight with Goma goes exactly the same. You know, use a Deku Nut or the Slingshot, and then hit it with a jump attack from your Deku Stick, you know? But in A Link to the Past, the battles are so fast, the battles are so fast-faced, and, you know, intense, and you take a whole bunch of damage if you get hit. They're over in less than a minute, but you can die in half that time. You know, scary. I don't know. Does this music fit? I'm not entirely sure. Dude, die. Most annoying enemy ever. Is there a key in here? No. What's in here? The fire rod. Holy crap, man. Then I have the big key, which is nice. I have to go looking for that. Do I need a key to get out of here? No, I don't. Okay, let's just... die! Urgh. Fiery Matt. I'm Fiery Bowser. Okay, I think there's always only one major item in a dungeon. Maybe? But I'm gonna look around anyway. Because these dungeons are definitely the parts that are that where you're most likely to miss stuff, which I think is cool, actually. I think it's a... Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Wait, I have magic powder. I can't believe that actually worked. Sorry, I went quiet there. I can't believe I actually did that. Why can't I? That's weird. Well, I'm glad I picked that up. Holy cow. Oh, you know what? Yeah, no, there's usually at least two big items. Or two, you know, abnormal items. Items that aren't like a map, a compass, and the big key in each dungeon. Because you get... Because the heart container from the boss and the major item of the dungeon are both shuffled out. Or are both shuffled. Somebody turn on the lights! I can't see shit! Okay, I don't think I'm... you know what? Fuck this. let's go to a different dungeon. I can't get into Misery Mire. If I had the flute, I would be able to get into Misery Mire. But I don't. I have the Moon Pearl, so I can go to Thieves Town now. Because I couldn't before, because I couldn't move the rock. Oh, and I have the hammer now, which means I can actually go into the dark world from the swamp. Dude, I'm trying to scratch my leg, and you just come and kick my ass. You know? Jeez.